do Liquid need to do kind of coming into game number two?
Not give away Tusk. Unfortunately, as we move into the draft, they gave away
into
Tusk
the draft.
Again.
Yeah.
You know, it was G-Rex, he asked him after their match yesterday, why do teams keep giving CTY Queen of Pain?
Yeah.
And the answer was pretty much because our Tusk is better.
Exactly.
He said, I mean, maybe it's one of those mind games things where you say it and it may or may not be true, but...
As we cut into the draft.
As we cut
into the draft, of course. Into the draft, where picks are happening. Right now, a couple of picks, maybe. I'm not too sure.
Well, possibly. The important thing is, the pick happened, which is the Tusk.
Of course.
Yep. So, yep. Game 3? Oh wait, there is no Game 3.
EHOME 1, Game 1.
Exactly,
it's not an auto draft. By no means.
Well, EHOME have opened up with a Tusk, as you talked about, and they get the Ancient Apparition, as you can see. And on the other side, Team Liquid. Undying and Winter Wyvern
gonna be the 1-2 punch there.
I mean, here's the thing, Kuro obviously knows the Tusk is good, and they last game they felt like trading the Doom for the Tusk was an okay trade for them. This time though, they do get Winter Wyvern and Undying, and judging from how that last game went, right, it was chaotic, it was kind of back and forth in long drawn out team fights, and there's just no better hero for a long drawn out team fight than Undying. If that Tombstone sticks, you land multiple decays, you just win the team fight.
Just admitting to me that Liquid are like, we're not looking to pull any punches. This is lane dominance right here. We got our Undying. You get your, you know, Jerix Wyvern, which I gotta say, you gotta remember at the start of that game, Liquid and their support play, they were like the unsung heroes. They had phenomenal ward coverage, which allowed them to really open up at the start. Something we're gonna be looking out for again here. So Tusk AA on the side of EHOME, obviously not giving away a lot of intel as far as what they're looking to do this time. So got to consider where Liquid want to take the game from here. But Tamamen no longer have the option for that Ember and that Slark. Do you commit for your late game early on if you're Liquid at this point?
More likely we see a Fata hero pickup, since I feel like Matumbaman is maybe the player who just plays a wider array of heroes and they have sort of more set preferences for Fata. Already we see Razor fanned out, so he's well, there we go. They're going to go back in the Alchemist. So
into the AA though? I mean, AA really counters Undying Wyvern in terms of the heals,
yeah.
Right? Now you pick another hero into it. I'm not sure whether I'm feeling this draft.
AA, I know. How can the AA?
And that's where, last game we saw the AA. I don't really feel like EHOME were actually planning to pick the ET. If AA was still in the pool, they would have picked AA over the ET. That's
yes.
Just like the Lan-M go-to as a five-position support. This game, they get in the first stage because they see two healers picked up, and while Liquid picking a third is just a bit crazy. But it does talk to the fact that Fata, what kind of heroes were left in the pool that he's been playing a lot of. Beastmaster, he doesn't feel like, well, maybe it's Kuro, he doesn't feel like it suits their playstyle, their drafts, their tournaments, so he hasn't been picking it for him. Alk, though, going to make a reappearance.
I understand the Beastmaster not being picked up because we see the Tusk Snowball plays. Okay, do you want your ultimate just completely get countered by a Blink Snowball, which is, you know, one of 11's bread and butters?
Oh, yeah. Now a Viper going to be the third choice here from the EHOME squad. Lane Dominator and very good when you got an Undying and Alk who need to get into the fray of the fight, now at risk of being kited about a little bit here. Not a showstopper, but it's going to get the job done.
More importantly, Team Liquid has a whole bunch of like random AoE spells where that Netherotoxin is going to be spread throughout, applying that a little bit extra slow, you know. At least in the laning stage, it's not going to be as bad against the Alchemist as the TA was.
Reserve time. So both teams still looking for their safe lane heroes. Matumbaman as well as CTY. CTY kind of popped, as well as Lina that we saw last game, both banned out. The Slark and Ember banned out this time around, so as far as the two players, the carry players, anything that kind of stands out as being like a go-to from Matumbaman when you're down a game that you want to pick Lumi or...
I mean, you guys mentioned Ember. I personally like it quite a bit.
Yeah, banned out though.
Yeah, okay, never mind.
Don't do that Huskar, that's for sure. Unless they really want to go
ballsy.
I mean,
they pick out into the...
yeah, I don't think that would be the smart choice for him.
Another hero that he's been playing a lot is Necrophos, but again, there is the AA.
Yeah.
So it's just...
Let's get five healers first AA strat.
Has he ever played maybe Slardar in that kind of safe lane position?
Oh, Slardar is quite good here. Very good, I think.
Yeah, actually.
That's
kind of completely
forgot
about the
but
hero.
But Liquid don't, like, traditionally play much Slardar. Not to say they can't suddenly say, look, we need a, this hero's going to fit, it's going to work our draft, let's go for it. So we'll see if Liquid do anything different here. The other thing is, some of these heroes can be kind of played in different roles. I was about to say, Undying can be a support, and they're going to actually do just that. They're going to put Clockwork in the off lane for mind control. the Undying as a support to go with whatever safe lane. Well, potentially in the safe lane, potentially in the dual lane with the Clockwork, and then last pick going to be Mutumba Man's hero.
Are you guys surprised, like, we don't see the Spirit Breaker being taken up here? I mean, it was such a big part of EHOME's victory last game.
It could be the fourth pick.
Exactly here, for EHOME, right?
Yeah.
I mean, the Tusk and Spirit Breaker on the front line gave so much space for the backline supports to cast a spell. Like, ET wouldn't be able to get off all his ultimates off. Like, it hit three or four people if it weren't for the Spirit Breaker and the Tusk. Amazing frontline.
Oh, I was just going to say, looking back on one of their older games
here.
They
love Shaker.
Yeah, they had that matchup against Digital Chaos where they already had the Tusk AA. They then pulled out the Shaker thereafter. Yeah. So going back in that Rolodex.
Yeah, a bit better synergy with the Ancient Apparition compared to the Spirit Breaker you were talking about. And just can put a bit more pressure on the lanes in the early game with rotations and fissures. We'll see what that leads CT Wine to picking. A hero I always think of whenever I see an Earthshaker is Klinks. These two work really well together.
Into the Wyvern, though, the embraces.
Sure, it's great against Alchemist, great at zoning a Clockwork.
Okay.
It's just kind of a niche pick. I've seen EHOME run once before in CTY. I don't know if we'll be seeing it again. Leshrac, actually, something EHOME bank link, so
there
no
you
clicks.
Go.
Leshrac's having LCTY's played as that kind of safe lane, snowballing, semi-carry.
In that matchup against DC, they pulled out the Sven as their core, EHOME. So, I don't know how it would work out here. I mean, you're going to get a man fight if that's what you're asking for with an Alchemist on the other side and Undying, but the interaction with Clockwork, it could be a bit difficult here, but it's actually Liquid now. We're looking for what we imagine being the Mutumba Man grab. We'll have to see. He might have to dig a bit deeper into his hero bowl than what we've been seeing from him as of recent, so not much reserve time here. Reserve time. Pressure on them. Juggernaut going to be the grab up here. Great mid-game presence.
Another
great
healing spell that gets countered by AA. This Ice Blast, if it hits, oh man.
Man, that's a man right there, Ursa! Gonna be come out, Direcide Ursa. Lots of melee cores across this one.
Yeah, I mean, for Liquid, though, just so limited in what, like, the safe lane carries were left. By no means is Jug being picked up for the healing ward, so I wouldn't be overly concerned about the Ice Blast dealing, like, stopping the Jug pick from being viable. I think it's just gonna be an aggressive fighting core that can create space for Fata once you see levels, you get level 7, you run around with Max Blade Fury and just cause problems.
Yeah, this also really explains the Earthshaker pick. Ursa just wants as much lockdown as possible, and right now you have amazing frontline nukes, and then of course the Chilling Touch, plus the Ice Vortex as extra damage and disable. And more importantly, Tusk Snowball could be used very offensively now. You could even roll in the Shaker for the ultimate, you could roll in the Ursa as initiation. I like how EHOME's lineup gel together a lot more.
I hope Lanham warmed up his jump shot, because if that Ice Blast connects bit here, it could prove to be very devastating for the lineup that Liquid have thrown together. But we'll have to see if that's going to be the case or not. We have hopped into game number 2, so with that, let's send it over to our casters right now. It's Odie Pixel and Mr. Ben Merlini Wu.
Thank you very much, Cole Guy, and indeed, the game has begun. This time, we're not having any pauses. We're getting ourselves straight into the action here between Liquid and EHOME. And Ben, indeed, we are seeing some, the Ursa coming out from EHOME. That's the notable one to bring up. And the fact that Liquid are running all these heals against an AA, which obviously on paper doesn't look great, but at the same time, if they're able to survive the Ice Blast, that's going to mean that they could just turn around, burst back up, jump straight back into the fight. So it can still work to their advantage.
I think the first pick, AA, was brilliant by EHOME, because it just counters so much of what Liquid like to do. They like the Huskar, they like the Necrophos, and of course the Undying and the Winter Wyvern that they already have. And it kind of saves you a lot of bans in the future part of the draft. But I'm actually a big fan of Ursa. I think he's slightly underpicked, but he does have the problem of getting kited a lot, especially versus the Winter Wyvern.
Indeed, and of course we are seeing some signature heroes on the side of Liquid. Mind Control on his Clockwork, a hero that is sometimes taken away from the team in the drafting stages. He is pretty damn good on this clock. Fada again on that Alchemist, as they were saying, and I felt the Fada's performance in game was pretty good. Like, I really liked the way that he built. It offered a lot to the fights. It was just unfortunate that at the end of the day, it wasn't enough to get them the win there.
Yeah, but a lot of people don't think that's the best way to play the Alchemist, because okay. you're not really using the best out of the most out of Greebel's Greed. And if you want to fight constantly and build fighting items, you might as well build something like, you know, a Razor that he okay. constantly plays. So it's not necessarily playing to the strength of the hero. I do think that he was kind of forced to play that way in the last game, but it was, you know, it's just something to consider for the Alch. And CTY on the Ursa is mid versus Alchemist. This is an extremely tough matchup for the Alchemist. There's like almost nothing that he can do because of the...
Oh, look at it, yeah. Father just being kept away slides. From the lane. CTY! Just holding him back. Gets a cheer from the crowd for that one. I mean, this is how you deal, as you said. Especially with the first point at Greevils, he's not going to be able to get any bonus gold. And just making sure that you're trying to shut him out from the XP as well at the start. So that you he's not going to get that acid spray up anytime soon. He's going to have it up shortly, but as you said, the start of this lane isn't going to be pretty for Fata.
Yeah, he really needs to kind of rely on stacks and...
And look, what? Is he just... No, he's got another one! He's going to do it! One more! Yeah, he's got it! First blood for CTY! He does lose his life, but I think that's worth it any day of the week.
Yeah, bold move by him. Nice Orb of Venom pickup and kind of trying to kill Fata before he's level 2 or has a stun at all.
Oh my goodness. That's punishing the kind of stuff you want to see from this Ursa mid. Yeah.
I think that's already boost for him too, so if you want to keep with the pressure, boost is much, much better than a bottle because Fata, he has to go his bottle Ooh. First before getting...
Sub lane, they got the Fisher out now. Kaka, he's going to complete the wall with his body and Lennon, but Blanca Chalk can still go the walk around. In fact, they've the clocks. Oh, works here, and Kaka, one more punch, the South, he's never moved, okay, South keeps him alive, that's it, oh, mid lane. We just can't take our eyes off mid lane, because CTY is just throwing himself at the Ursa, at the Alchemist, he's killed him again, does lose his life. Okay, the Ursa mid, I mean, there's some issues here for Fata, it's very YOLO here from EHOME, but, okay, mind control, again, just playing with, on the edge of his life.
People have been searching for out counter for maybe, you know, close to a few weeks now, and the general consensus was that a heavy lane dominator such as Queen of Pain was probably the best option, but EHOME seemed to have one up their sleeve with the Ursa. Oh, he's going phase boots. Screw the bottle, man.
Oh man, if he gets those he's got 20 gold and he's got the phase. I mean, what would you do if you fought it? You've got an unstable concoction.
But the thing is, level you can't get the runes at all.
Second. Yeah.
Like, there's almost no chance you can get the bounty rune if Ursa's around, because he'll just chase you down. So he kind of needs either a lot of lane pressure from his teammates, so that maybe he can get like the support to rotate around, or maybe even just like a lane swap or going to the jungle at this point, because his CS is abysmal. It's 2 CS, 3 minutes in for Fata. That is not something you see very often.
And they've got to do this, they've got to keep Jarex mid. If they have the Jarex mid, it's going to be harder for CTY to, of course, find the kills, and he goes and again. Look at the damage, there's half of the health book on the turnaround with the concoction, the slow from the Arctic burn. CTY just hangs about. He is not phased at all. As shoes will be there, as the courier on its way, phase boots will be there. Kaka and 11 have come in with a smoke as well. They want to kill Fata again. Oh my goodness, if they can get the setup here with an ice shards, Fata, he's in a lot of trouble. There is Jarex here, but he's got the corn embrace. The three heroes hanging around, can they still go for it? Yeah, they'll go back in, stuns himself there, couldn't get it out because of the corn embrace timing. Oh, disaster for Liquid in the mid lane. EHOME. This Ursa pick and the Ursa performance so far, doing it for the side.
Now what do you do? Stack and recover? I think that's kind of your only option is Elk.
This is quite something that we're seeing it. I mean, we certainly put Jarex mid. It's not enough to save the Alchemist. I mean, what do you do to recover this lane now?
Yeah, I think you have to stack and you have to try and gank him at the first rush, but with Ursa having this good of a start, he's already level 5 with phase boots, it's going to be really tough to stop that. They kind of need some more mileage out of the Undying.
Every lane as well, Ben. Look at the top lane. You got level 5 on the old Chicken Viper, he's had fine CS and he's just zoning out mind control, he's just level 2 on the clock. It's looking to be a tough start for Liquid. Oh, the Fisher coming out as well. Make sure he doesn't get the concoction out. CTY, very nicely done there from Kaka on the Shaker. This is looking like a hard beginning for Liquid.
Yeah, it really is. Viper is, you know, going to win his matchup almost certainly. Mid, just complete ownage from CTY. And I guess bottom lane is kind of what they're looking out for. But, you know, Undying can only stack and pull for so long before you're forced to go out and help your team.
Kaka on the high ground. Maybe seeing if he can set up a Fisher if Fata comes out. too far. Jarax is still there. So we're trying to help him. And yeah, as you said, the bottom lane, this is kind of the saving grace for Liquid at the moment. The fact that Matumba Man, obviously nothing's been done from the side of EHOME really to contest him. 11's been around the map a little bit. So this Juggernaut is going to get a decent amount of farm here in this early game and is top of the CS at the moment.
Let's see what build TTY is going for. Yeah, he's also going for the 1-1-3. 3-1-1 is the more standard mid build, but if you're doing this well, you can actually just sneak and roach because you have a lot of control of the map with the 1-1-3. I think he can actually do it right now.
And the tempo seems to have slowed down now a little bit for the sides. So we're seeing that both Jarax and, of course, Mind Control even hanging around the mid lane at level 3 just to see if they can catch out any dives. And they're making their attention towards 11, and Jarax here with a wraparound. I'm starting to get the slow onto Tusk. Oh, the shards. Very nicely done. You're not killing 11 that easily. Blocked anyone else off any other chance from the side of Liquid.
So maybe with the bounty rune here, Fada can come back from the early game.
He's going to get the haste rune, unluckily for himself, and 11 will find the bounty on the bottom. TTY CS in the mid lane, 26 for 14. Still continue to be quite a bit ahead here of Fata on the Alchemist.
So they have this Observer Ward that's going to stay up though. That's going to be pretty big because they have like 3 melee heroes. It's pretty hard to jump, like with Ursa plus Tusk plus Shaker. So, you know, with this Observer Ward, it's going to be much easier for them.
And just look at just the level difference as well between CTY and Fata. The fact that Fata's had to have people around hanging in and he's just sitting at level 4 and you've got level 7 now on the Ursa. And it's just 6 minutes in to have this difference. It's going to be greatly painful here for the mid of Liquid.
They're actually getting a lot of levels up on Lanham. That's a big deal, having that Ice Blast up later. So, stack and recovery for Fada, not the worst thing in the world. You die a couple of times, it's not a big deal.
Yes.
So see early mask already coming out from CTY. The Roche, he could be doing Roche like any time now.
I mean, do you think they will look for a very early Roche in the sense that can Liquid contest it with their lineup at this point again?
If you don't contest the first one, like, it's so much harder to contest, like, okay, the next 5 minutes because he has a...
Bottom lane. We're gonna see 11. Playing footsie here with Matumba Man. Training hits it. Matumba Man moving in, and that's it. There we go, with the Omni Slash gets the kill. Very nicely done there by Matumba Man.
Yeah, I guess they probably need some more levels, though, on their heroes. Let's see what Viper's going for. Looks like early mech coming out from Old Chicken.
As you said, just playing it safely, Liquid now, just getting that farm up on the Alchemist, trying to catch him back up. Which they will be eventually able to do. And okay, here we go. They're going to look for the smoke, and they're going to go for Roche here.
Yeah, this is a really tough time for them to contest, though. They already dropped the Central Ward in preparation, and it's kind of obvious because no one's mid, but, I mean, what are they really going to send? Alk is not that good fighting the pit. Undying is only level 5 at this point with maybe 3 points in Tombstone, but he has to be the one that gets there, like, right now.
Oh, this...
It's already way too low.
Yeah.
It's too late.
CTY's got it. 8 minutes in, this man, the flare will come out, the pings come in, but nothing that Liquid can do to head over there. And they are just going to have to let CTY take it. He gets the Roche. Doesn't even pick up the Aegis straight away because he knows that no one's going to come in for it. Just chills out. Gets the DD. Aegis? No? Okay. Leave it there. Does no one want the Aegis? Is there a reason, Ben? What is this strat? Is this...
Don't ask me, man.
What's going... Okay, don't worry. Top lane. Okay, okay. Blade Fury on top of Chicken. Is the Aegis... Yep. Aegis is still there. Okay. Well, the lane, CZY is starting to push with the DD. Okay. Ben, what's going on?
I don't know what they're waiting for. I'm still trying to...
I'm still waiting for someone to go there. I mean, I guess they just don't need it. They're very confident, apparently, EHOME. Who needs Aegis? Let's just push this tower. They'll maybe casually pick it up on the way back after
somebody
taking the tier 1.
Somebody has to notice.
I mean, this is efficiency. They had a DD. They wanted to make sure that they could get it straight on the tower. They've got a dire ward up, so maybe they just feel that there's no way that Liquid's going to come and just take it.
I mean, it's worth, I think, blowing a smoke on someone like a Wyvern and kind of fly in. Right?
CTY is going to go back and get it now, I'm sure. Now, if he had an Aegis here, he might still be fine. There's a Tombstone drop. I don't even know anymore, Ben. they're gonna lose Kaka as well! Has anyone got the Aegis? No. Oh, no! Okay, Lana. What are you doing? Oh, my. Okay, 11 did turn it around. He managed to find the Wyvern. Monk's jaw's fairly low. The courier? What? He's feeding the courier? What? Okay, they'll get Kuroki. Okay, they're still fighting well. Double kill here. They'll get mind control. Okay, so it's going to be a good fight here for EHOME. They do find 3 kills in a very weird fashion. Courier's being baited. Aegis just... Maybe Lanham goes back and takes it.
I just saw Kuroki.
There we go. No. Just checking it's still there. He's just checking up on it. Here we go. CTY was like, oh, guys, I think I forgot to pick this up before the last fight. There we go. There we go. There we go. There we have it. Well done, CTY. Okay. Finally, I think he's, lost for words here.
That was quite entertaining.
Okay.
He played like he had the Aegis. I think he thought he...
Yeah, it was the mind games. Okay, I mean, so 11 minutes in, 6-6. Overall, what are we seeing in terms of a difference now? It's 2K, so it is still obviously EHOME with the lead. And they did still obviously get the kill on Russia. Mind control, smoked up now with Jerax. He's got a hook shot. Let's see if he can set something up in the mid lane.
We don't want to go on him. He's not a good target.
Yeah, level 9 Viper. 3 points in Corrosive Ogre Club. Fairly tanky, as you're saying, for this point, 11 minutes in. And there's some counteraction from EHOME. If Liquid did jump in, they've got a full 5-man towards this mid lane.
Yeah, let's see. No Observer Awards, though. I guess they have one on Kuro. But EHOME know that all they need to do is stick around S5 and kind of let Ursa just do his thing with the Aegis. He is so strong at this point in the game. And on top of that, I think he has a Blink Dagger coming?
He's got the Blink now. Yeah, he's got another DD as well. Smoke up straight away. That's what feels like 2 DDs in the row for CTY. He's going up towards bottom.
Change gears, he's at that magic mark.
Okay, going for the farm build, yeah. And he's going to hope... Has he got a courier out there? Because if he goes down now with that amount of gold on him, it's not going to be great. Okay, he's playing it safe. Realizes that they're off the map. He's not going to get caught out, so there we go. So that is... Has he... How much money has he got? Yeah, 5 gold to go. So he's going to have that first major kind of hurdle cross. Top lane, Matumba Man will take himself a tower. So still the farm here for the Juggernaut, looking very good. 5.6 hit gold on this jerk. Jarrett's getting himself away from EHOME as they did move into him on the mid lane. They'll be able to find the space here to find themselves a T1 here, though. So some more money into the bank of EHOME.
So Liquid's getting a lot out of the map, and this is kind of one of the best ways to deal with Urza, who's had a really good early game. He's not actually that great like in BKB wars. He gets kited fairly easily unless he's just out of control with an Abyssal, but they're just trying to split push and not fight at all with the Radiance eventually coming out on Alk. Just kind of try and play safe.
Mind control. He's going to get found out here. He does have a TP and a hookshot. It's nighttime, so they can't quite get the vision. They're going to... Is Kaka going to go to the right now? I think he's just out of vision here, and he knows exactly what's going on mind control just because of this warden. He's going to stick around and farm the camp here. Feeling safe enough. CTY with the DD, making use of it in the jungle as well. Bottom lane, things are coming out onto old Chicken. Matumba Man moving forward. He's level 11 with that Omni Slash online. But I mean, the Ursa and the Viper still very much at the top of the farm game. Looks like it's going to be the SMY coming out for Old Chicken next in the item build. And there is now a mech complete as well on 11's Tusk. So the man fighting, the team fighting power of EHOME is going to be pretty terrifying if they jump straight into Liquid.
And CTY is going full man mode. Yeah. Getting Mask of Mana. Screw the Vlads.
And he's getting all the good runes here as well. He's got himself an invis, so he might even be able to set something up with that if he wants to the mask comes out.
They might consider like getting a gem pretty early just so they can stop this eventual split push. You want to go before he gets the...
They're trying to move in onto Old Chicken. There's an Omni Slash. The Fisher will hold back Juggernaut. He's trying to get in, but he can't get the Omni Slash off. Now the Coffee's down and he's kind of panicking. He gets the play view here to avoid the Coffee prop, but he's just going in with the punches. Cut. Here's your Ice Blast flying through. Is he going to hit the top? Yes! Straight on the face. Bang on target. Juggernaut down. Jax will heal himself up, but there's 5 heroes here on the side of EHOME. They'll get the Wyvern as well. Killing spree for the Tusk. And 2 more onto the kill spree of the side of EHOME. 8-6 now on the board.
Still pretty good. They have this really nice Observer Ward. Kind of scout out how many are there and able to play around that. Still very nice play from the fog and not getting Omni slashed by Old Chicken.
Okay, so we've got the Radiance up on Fata. So as we mentioned earlier, a very different kind of build to what he did in game 1. Do you think this could potentially be the answer to dealing with the position there in top lane? Kuroki just chomped down by CTY. Bottom lane at the same time, EHOME continuing to pressure the tier 2.
I mean, that's the only way you kind of deal with this, right? Is split pushing and taking it late.
CP's coming in, hook shot forward as well. Kaka does have an echo slam if he wants to get off, he does. Damage engine gonna go onto the Blade Fury Jug, Jug moving forward with the snowball. Saving Kaka brings him in. They'll go straight onto Fodder. The Omni Slash comes out, it's huge. Finds one, maybe punches the ice blast onto Fodder. They'll blow him off, Hulk's down. 11, he might just get out of it as well. Move himself away. No, he goes, does the rocket flare. But to a moment, the cold feet will proc an old chicken around him, just trying to work down this juggernaut. He realizes he's done have the damage with the Blade Fury. He's gotta get himself out, won't be able to. It'll be a 2-for-2 trade, make that 3-for-2. CTY just jumping in on the back lines, cleaning up the clockwork. And he's going to be fine. He's got the ult if he needs to, and he can blink out. So he's going to be okay, but 3-for-2 trade there for EHOME. Getting far to getting Mutumba, man, the kills that matter. And it looks like they'll also get a tier 2 here as well, Ben.
Again, nice place coming out from the Tusk, forcing the Juggernaut to commit his Omni Slash to a target that he didn't really want to. And we're going to see Roche respawn pretty darn soon. So, Alk just needs to keep doing what he's doing. They have a ward on top, and he kind of has access to an opponent's jungle, although his own jungle has been sworn by EHOME.
Yeah, no, I mean, as you were saying, this is going to be pretty nice for EHOME, the fact that the respawn timer is so short here on Roche. So they are going to be able to have a go for it and get it and go for some more action very, very shortly, of course. Overall difference in terms of gold, 5k at the moment favoring the side of EHOME. We'll see if the side of Liquid can catch back up. Obviously, Fada starting to step up his farm with this Radiant. And is this going to be a smoke? Yes, it is from Liquid. They've got the smoke. They will go. They've got the hook shot available at the moment. Both 11 and Kaka up here. Kaka 1300 towards his blink, but they're actually going to make a movement towards the mid lane Liquid. They see Lanham and Old Chicken coming quite far out here. They might just catch C2R in the back of it, but he is level 11 and he may just turn and go here. Now, yeah, he's actually going to get popped away by the cogs, and Mind Control just TP's out. Doesn't want to fight, and it looks like the rest of Liquid will do so as well. Jarex gets himself out, so a little bit of an unsuccessful smoke there from the side of Liquid, unable to find anything.
He can buy so much time with his ultimate, so it's not really a good option for them. And EHOME trying to do their best to limit their farm. They do not know that they have these Observer Wards over here. They didn't think that they could get them down, especially with one of their own. But Liquid making very good use of the map right now.
And we're going to see towards the mid, Mind Control, maybe trying to get himself into position on the side. EHOME, well, for 4, committing to the push. Kaka, he has got that Echo Slam back online here as well. But Liquid, they've got the Winter's Curse, they've got the Omni Slash. They want to try and fight into it. And EHOME just being very careful with the positioning here, backing themselves off. Mind Control will spot that Roshan is up. And he's actually going to sit there with an Invis. I wonder if he'll try and do something a bit sneaky if the Ursa comes along. Where is Ursa at the moment? Ursa, is he going to make a way over there? No, it looks like they really want to fight here. They're still looking for something towards mid, hoping that someone comes out into the jungle here.
But CTY? He's not going to take that much damage because he does have lifesteal, so...
Is CTY going to go in the pit now? Mind Control's still got half the duration of the Invis. He's not going to be... No, CTY's not going for it. So they're not going to be able to do anything. Meanwhile, Mutumba Man, he's been found out. EHOME closing onto the Juggernaut. The Ice Shards block onto Mutumba Man. The punch as well together. So the Echo Slam to just lock him down. Make sure he can't get off the Omni Slash and they kill him just in time before he can get that ult up there. And Mind Control, realizing he's not going to be able to find anyone in the pit, will end up just leaving top lane. And Darwin, he's supporting out the TP out from Fada. Kuroki's still around here. Now, let me see if they can chase him down. They've got the shards. Kuroki's going to look to probably just TP out in the side shop. And 11. Don't know if he'll be able to... Is he going to look for him? Nah, it doesn't look like he's going to look that deep. So Kuroki is going to be all right there.
Mind Control hanging out here.
He hung around in the pit. Now he's hanging around out here.
I don't think he can solo kill Ursa if he finds him. And I think it's maybe hoping for a kill on Lanham. But he's going to have his 4 step up pretty soon. So the chances for him to kill anyone is really, really low.
And top lane, Kuroki's still hanging around. The pings have come in as well, so he's trying to call for some backup. Wants to try and go for this kill on 11. They have got Mind Control with the hook shot. As soon as this wave's burst down, we'll see if it goes through. But Kaka's there with the Fisher as well. This is going to be a hard fight for Liquid to take. I don't think you want to be jumping into this one with just the two of you.
Yep, and they have Blink Dagger now on the Ooh. Shaker. But I don't know, you might see them when he goes to purchase it.
Yep, there's your Blink. Kuroki. Liquid at the moment, there's a lot of people just hiding across the map. Posing themselves in in a position ready to jump, but I don't know if they're going to get the opportunity. Maybe Wakaka coming back into the shop. Mind Control now has got Fata behind him as well, but these are good. They just seem like hard catch-offs and pick-offs for them to find, and they're just not finding them at the moment, Liquid.
So, guess it's all in on the Alchemist basket here. Nice. The OT's up from him. He doesn't really have that many lanes that he can farm. So, better to go Manta, so you can kind of extend your territory a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, yeah, if he gets the Manta, the Octarine, Boozy Travels, he's going to be able to maintain the lane pushes out and just kind of keep the game going as long as possible to buy time for the rest of his team. But it's going to be quite an ordeal for Fata, and as you said, I feel like a lot of pressure's on this out. CCY, of course, takes the Roshan. This time he does pick up the Aegis straight away. Ping's coming out on top it. Darker hiding in the trees. Echo Slam's going to be back up in 15, and there's going to be TP down to the tier 2 from Viper as well. Old Chicken, 600 away from the BKB, and they're just going to TP out. Well, at least one of them's going to try. He looks for the council, finds it onto Kuroki. So now Kuroki has been left behind. He's going to go for this TP now on the sideline, as he didn't do it out, and nicely done there. So Kuroki didn't initially TP out at the same time, just in case that came in. Mind Control going very YOLO here. He is on his own. Might get car cut, but he's not going to do so. Okay. I was a little bit YOLO there from the clock. I mean, he nearly did get the kill, but even so, just getting the Shaker and losing the offlaner's life.
Just trying to make the game go as long as possible so that...
Okay. CCY moving on to Fata. They'll get the Unstable Concoction stun off. Have they got the control? The Ice Blast flying through. It's not going to latch on, and that looks like it's going to be enough for CTY to not go too ham.
EHOME has committed to all these early game items with, you know, S&Ys on a couple of their heroes. But as we've seen from
last game, again. Oh, okay. Snowball onto Vard, they get the Corkish out, they've probably got the damage to kill him though before he can throw out. No, they do throw out CTY, but they're slow there from the Sigil. Lure away the Vard, gets out, they'll get the kill on the Alchemist, he's down for 50 seconds. Tombstone doing a fair bit, the Mecha's been popped. Oh, Chicken's turned up as well, there's now a Blink on the Tusk. So more and more items being found here by the side of EHOME. 7.5, coming up to 10k lead in terms of net worth. Things are getting better and better here for the dive side.
Yeah, they're not really able to get that much farm up on a Matumba man. It's just Alk, and Alk still cannot man fight an Ursa into the late game, especially when he's this far behind.
Matumba man. Hiding in the trees.
Like, you know, 5,000 gold ahead of everyone.
Okay, he has got the Oni. He's gonna go for the straight TP out. That's the smart thing to do, or just one more swipe, but he was gonna. He was a goner. That was lucky. Very, very close there for the Juggernaut. And Jarek's just hiding in the tree line. He's going to TP himself out as well.
But this is not the type of game that Liquid had, I think, expected coming out from EHOME. I don't think they expect the Fata to get dominated so hard. They have good early game heroes, but just lost the lanes out way too hard and kind of forced to play this backup plan.
Mind Control with an Invis rune. What's he going to do? He's not going to want to jump out straight away because EHOME, they're there in full force, ready to find the mid lane. Ice Blast gets thrown out, won't catch anyone. In fact, 11, blinking onto Kuroki here, has found the Undying all on his own here. There's backup coming in as well for the side of EHOME. So Kuroki in a spot above, a CTY joins the fight, makes short work there of the Undying. Mind Control still hanging around with his Invis. See if he can set something up. Okay, walks up into the sentry that was just beautifully placed. Okay.
He's playing like a bounty hunter, man. I don't know how he gets so many Invis runes, though.
It's not still going too well for him.
With the Manta, there's a slight hope for Liquid. They can keep getting up farm.
And in the jungle, Matumba man going for the TP. This time it would not work! The damage from CTY! Okay, Courier as well. Courier as well there for the Ursa.
Somebody
CTY. We talk about his quad performance. I think people will be talking about the Ursa performance after this game as he's been coming out with some blinders. 9 kills, 3 deaths, 2 assists. And overall, just EHOME's play as a team just seeming a lot stronger than Liquid this game.
Yeah, I like the Mask of Madness too, and ended up getting the kill on the Juggernaut when he commit to this. He can also just get bashed earlier and no one can really TP away from him. But Liquid, they just really can't do anything at all. Just hope that Alchemist can get large enough at some point and maybe start feeding some ags to people, but that's, you know,
it's a long way off
down the line. Yeah. With the next Aegis and Cheese, I think Liquid might be forced to fight a high ground defense that they don't really want to take.
It's all lame. Ice Blast is flying up. Kaka maybe was looking to see if he could find someone out. Mind Control might be able to get the solo kill here. Moves in onto the Earthshaker. And yeah, they should be able to get Kaka. Pops it. Oh, is he going to live? He's going to live. 11 coming in with the saves, with the mech and the snowball, just in case there was any follow-up. And this man, we've talked about it in game one, why teams don't like to give him the Tusk. He's always got his teammates back. Mid lane, the fight's kicking off as well. They're trying to move in, and Matumba Man's got the Blade Fury. Maybe seeing if they can turn it. Tombstone's been dropped. There's your Omni Slash, the old Chicken BKB. Is he going to save the CGI? Looking for the Tombstone. He has still got the Aegis here, though. And he might not even lose his life here. He just forced away the Concoction should do it, though. No! He's still alive? Nah, he's gone. But he's got the Aegis. There's four heroes here on the side of Liquid. Can he get himself away from this? No, Winter's Curse. They'll get the kill, and it's a big one. Oh, hang on. No. CTY's a gunner. And that's Juggernaut getting that streak as well. 800 gold here pretty much, and oh, they might find Lanham. No, four staff across. Lanham, can they get themselves around in time to catch out the AA? Just going to throw down the Ice Vortex to slow them, and Lanham. Yeah, he's getting pursued here. The Kuroki coming around as well from the side, but it looks like they'll give up on it, and Lanham will be able to get himself out of there. But nonetheless, big pick-off for Liquid in the sense that they do kill CTY's Earths in that mid lane.
Yeah, good maneuvering by them. They're kind of able to drag EHOME around the map with the threat of the Alchemist farming everywhere. He's actually somewhat pulling ahead in net worth, but I think that he can way out-farm the Ursa at this pace, because Ursa just went for a pure like hero-killing build, as well as Roche. So I think with the next Aegis and Cheese, they probably want to make a move on the high ground. Ideally, you want the Ursa to tank the Omni Slash and just pop in Rage as soon as he hits. But unfortunately, it went on the Viper that time.
Bottom lane, pings are coming out to Jarax. 11. Ready with the blink. Jarax continuing to come out the lane. See towards the mid that Kaka is pinging out onto the Jug. That's going to be the Blade Fury coming out straight away. If they can lock him in, oh, he's actually going to move under the Ice Blast here. Kaka moving forward, tried to look for the Fissure Block. Oh, does he actually still get it here? He does. Matumba Man's going to look for the TP out. But, oh, no, he can't get through the block. It was successful from Kaka. There's the farm from 11, the Echo Slam to the face. A beautiful position from Kaka, just getting off the block needed with that Fissure in top lane. TTY jumps on Mind Control. He's got a Basher complete. And that's the clock down here as well. Liquid just getting torn apart across the map here, hero by hero.
Yeah, that was a sick link block.
Yeah, really well calculated there for the Shaker. Jarax. Oh, Jarax. He's going to fly off over the tree line, old chicken. On his own, you've got Lana moving in. There is an Ice Blast. No, he's going to be fine, Jarax. Lana can't quite get in range to do anything, but Kaka. Maybe looking for the wraparound here. Jarax is back up to base, so he'll be fine. 20 seconds until the Jug's back here. Top lane's being forced in by CTY. He's continuing to get richer and richer on the Ursa. Vata's farm has picked up. I mean, he is on the outs as expected, but he is still top of the net worth. 2.7k on top of the bots, Manta, and Radiance. But we very well might see EHOME just try and force these fights up to the high ground after they take down this final tier 2.
Yeah, I definitely think they should. It's going to come to a point where once he has Octarine, you're not going to be able to swiftwatch out your lanes. Oh. It's not like they have
Mind Control coming in, but the fish is there. They'll just turn around onto the clock and disassemble him. He's down. Omni Slash coming out to CTY, but there's just no damage. He's got the Glimmer Cape. He has got the Enrage as well. He'll try and walk it off. Liquid are moving in. Lanham, he's got an Ice Blast up, and he's going to look to try and set up to multiple. Here's the Snowball, saving the Ursa from the Winter's Curse. The Fissure coming out. Lanham's still looking at the Ice Blast. They've lost the Ursa here. Maybe this is the fight for Liquid. Ice Blast comes out. It's going to connect onto the heroes. Multiple heroes, three heroes. Kaka moving in onto Fada. He's not regenerating up. Even the Corn Embrace isn't going to save him. 11 might just get himself away. The Illusion's chasing him down. Has he got the burn damage? He does. Kuroki gets a double kill, but they'll lose the Alchemist here. Owl Chicken moves in with the BKB. So a bit of a messy fight there for EHOME. 2-3. So Liquid will be happy with that one. One of the better fights that they've seen in the last 15 minutes.
Yeah, they're able to deal, even despite the sick plays from Tusk, they still managed to take down the Ursa. It's pretty big. Do they have a blink on Tusk?
Yes, they got the blink hand mech, yeah. And okay then, now the Medallion as well, 600 on top. Roshan is going to be back up in just over a minute. So I'm sure we'll see them better. Matumba Man saving up a lot of gold here on top of the SMY. I mean, what is going to be the item pickup for this Jug that's going to help Liquid in this time of need?
Let's see, it's too late for a Battle Fury build. I guess he might go Blink just so he can keep Swift pushing out, or even Manta Style so he can extend the area by just sending out illusions everywhere.
Oh, Kaka. Okay, he's going for the solo here on mind control, and he's going to get it as well. Kaka on the shaker. What a player.
It's just tough because he's really far behind, and like, even if you go, like, what's a good manfight item versus the Ursa? Like, once he gets an Abyssal, he's going to be able to destroy the Juggernaut, so I think he has to go for more utility, play for, like, the 55-60 minute win.
Well, coming down to the bottom. Jax, again, we've seen him down in this position a lot of times. He's never really been caught out. He's been able to play it quite safely here. 11 will just cut the creep wave. Old Chicken starts to push it back round. The ping's coming out now. Jax will get himself out. I think they realize they can't necessarily go for that one. Roshan is back up now. So we'll see if CTY heads over there fairly shortly. He's got the SMY Basher and 1800 gold on top of his build so far. 1400 gold. And still Old Chicken been farming very well on this Viper. He's now managed to pick up a Reaver on top of the SMY and the BKB.
Yep, still going for what, Shadow Blade now on Juggernaut, and with like mass blinks, with Manta illusions and regular illusions. EHOME still not going to be able to find the fight that they're looking for to cut off Liquid's head and end the game.
And as you said, they do need to.
They lost the gem too, so that's kind of a big blow to EHOME.
Because as you were saying earlier, if Fada gets this Octarine online, it's certainly going to step up the difficulty for the side of EHOME.
Yeah, I don't know if they're far enough ahead, even with the next Roche, to end the game. It's going to be really difficult, but if Liquid, like, you know, lose Alchemist or something like that, then that's definitely the green light for EHOME. But as of this point, it's still kind of a tenuous lead that they're holding.
And Timberman just moving around here with the Shadow Blade. Seeing if he can catch anything. Old Chicken did finish off that heart now. It's incredibly tanky here on this Viper. Okay, so Liquid, they know the Roche is up. Rocket Flare from Mind Control scouts it out. Top lane, maybe look for CTY. CTY will TP out. And he himself is going to make a beeline straight for the pit. And once again, I don't think Liquid are going to be able to do anything to stop this. As it will fall incredibly quickly. And this, of course, will be the Aegis and the Cheese hit.
I think this is it. They just got a heart completed on Viper. So this is time to go.
Yeah.
Ideally, I guess maybe you want the Abyssal on CTY, give him the last hit here, maybe do like one or two Ancients and then go for it, but that might be too slow because they're getting their top lane pushed in.
Okay. Old Chicken and Kaka hanging around. There's Matumba Man and Mind Control in the jungle. Yeah, bottom lane 11 just starts to get straight in, gets himself in position. If anyone comes out, just checking if someone like Jarax is hiding in the jungle once again. Ping's coming out on Old Chicken on the top. He's got the full fight ban moving in, looking to maybe try for this Viper kill, but he's got 3k HP. Our five heroes now. Let's see if they can get. They don't get the slow hit from the initial Splinter Blast, but the Arctic Burn comes in. They're a little bit too scared to dive this one, Liquid. They realize it's a hard kill, and they know that there'll be reactions from the rest of EHOME, so they do commit five, and unfortunately for the side of Liquid, doesn't look like they'll find anything with it.
So they have, like, great vision with all these Observer Wards and Illusion scouting out. They have vision of, like, half the map, which is much more than you'd expect from a team in their position.
And EHOME, I'm going to have the BKB here on CTY. BKB and Cheese is going to be on the man for the next fight.
Yeah, he doesn't have slots for it, though, and they're still not able to deal with the Alks constantly pushing out the lanes everywhere.
Okay, Omni Slash, nicely done. You were talking about the warding here from Liquid, the sentries there, laying that one onto the Shaker. Limicade wasn't going to save him.
Gem cooldown is just a couple of minutes, but that's a big blow, that fight on top, because now they lost control of their jungle already.
Top lane, Old Chicken feeling confident to come out. He's not going to be too scared at all, especially seeing as last time Liquid sent five up here and they were even too scared to make a jump on him. Jarax hanging it back. I mean, Liquid have kind of managed to step it down the pace a bit in mid lane. Okay, CTY moving in onto Garoki here, gets the kill straight in the base there. There's a wraparound coming from Mind Control. That's got this yet another invis rune on this clock. Right, he's getting these time and time again. He's going to see Lanham here. Is he going to try for the solo? Sure, there's a 4-star on Lanham, so it's going to be hard. CTY getting kites down the mid lane. Timberman moving in. Here comes the cogs out, but Lanham forces himself out. They've got the hookshot to follow up. Nicely done there. So they'll find the kill onto AA. CTY will be able to escape.
Getting picked apart by the split push from Liquid. Still, I don't know if they're going to be able to use the Aegis. What, 2.5 minutes left? such a small window with Gem. They need to take time to deward all these wards, and it looks like it's going to be maybe the fourth Rosh that maybe.
Midlane Karka forcing Blinken into position with the Echo to start the lockdown onto Timberman. CTY with the bashes. Juggernaut down for 80 seconds. Beautiful initiation there from Earthshaker, just closing a massive distance and straight in with a bang on target Echo to lock down Jug.
I think that's an acceptable death, though. Vada's going to be pushing the T2s, still no BOTs. They were not geared up for this sort of game, though. Like, ideally you want, you know, Shadow Blades, Blinks, the same as Liquid's getting to try and pick off these split pushes constantly, bypass the illusions that has the Radiance, but as of this point, they're forced to look for more team fights.
Bottom lane, Kaka. He's got the Glimmer Cape here, Fada charging up the concoction. There's a shot across, but that's... Oh, he's gonna hold Fada back, so he stuns himself. Now the Ice Blast comes in, it's gonna hit Fada here, they've got the burst, they bring down the out. Mind Control's gonna go down as well, and a real mess for the side of Liquid there in that bottom lane. And I'm nearly dying, that's the Acid Spray and the Radiant Spray, but he is gonna be fine.
That's really nice play though, coming out from Kaka, using the Glimmer Cape to get the jump on these heroes. They think they're safe because there's no TPs on the tower.
It's a buyback here from Mind Control. Hookshot's still going to be on cooldown for 30 seconds. CTY and 11 have been putting on the pressure at this top lane. You can see Lanham and Old Chicken start to wrap themselves around to mid so they can start to join this push. Jug's going to be back up here. Does have the Omni Slash on Matumba Man. There's still 35 seconds before Father's back in the game. And here we go. CTY just manning up, getting a few chips onto the tower.
It's this only is too it. Strong.
Yeah, the EHOME, they do need to get this push on because we've seen that Fada, as you said, he's got the Octarine 2k of gold on top of it as well. But still, the overall kind of favoring at this moment, it's 12k lead for EHOME, which is still pretty impressive when you look at the fact that most of the net worth of Liquid is just on this Alchemist. And here we go. What's going to be Liquid's answer here?
It's only 30 seconds left on the Aegis. They can kind of use the cogs to block them off, but it's definitely stall until that Aegis is up and then go.
And Echo is back online for Kaka in 4 seconds. So if Liquid do make a jump... Oh, hang on. BKB pop by CTY here. A little bit of a mistake here from the man. As BKB is going to now be on cooldown, I think EO will probably... I want to stick around here. I mean... Yeah, that, not great there for CTY. Bit unfortunate.
So now they have BOTs up on Shaker. That's going to be pretty useful in dealing with Alk. Wonder what his next item is. I guess he has a safer buyback. He thinks that they're going to high ground push and end the game fairly swiftly.
Bottom lane, Mind Control. He's just going to go out and try and force that one out. Majority of EHOME putting the pressure mid, and that's the Gem coming back out. So Tusk will pick that up for the side. 11. They continue to maintain that map control. I mean, what is the plan here for Liquid? Is it pretty much just stall the game, stick to the high ground,
yeah,
push the lanes out?
Yeah, what they've been doing for the past 15 minutes.
Yep.
But unfortunately, they have the Aegis now, so that's a slight issue for them. But just keep getting picks where you can.
A lot of money racking back up on Old Chicken as well. He's got 3.2k coming in, so he'll probably be able to... I guess he'll look for the damage now that he's got the heart. Is there anything else that could offer to the high ground push?
Is that the
ACO Shivas? Like, what's he going for here?
Probably, it looks like AC, I suppose. It's pretty good if you actually want to push high ground, but the problem is they can't really get there in the manner that they wanted.
Top lane, Kaka, he's been found by Fada. He's got the Glimmer Cave, the Omni Slash will be whiffed. And he may just go back in here. He's got an Ice Blast flying through. Can they stop him from getting out here? They need a Blink. No, we'll be able to stop him. The Timberman is able to get out. They're able to keep their heroes alive, which is pretty much what they just need to be doing at this point. Clockwork. Oh, Mind Control. If CTY makes the move around here, could be in trouble. The pings are coming out. They're spotting him. CTY will jump in, and the Abyssal Blade now complete on the Ursa. Locks down the clock, gets himself another kill. And this bear proving to still be a massive issue for the heroes of Liquid. I know Jarax is around as well, but... Always going to be hard to catch out, and he will be able to get himself away on the Winter Wyvern, but CTY still managing to just disassemble it. And the BKB has come out on the Timberman, but I still feel he needs a lot more really to be as effective as he needs to at this point of the game, 40 minutes in.
Yeah, they can just annihilate people with the Abyssal. He has so much front-loaded damage that it has to be like big plays coming out from Winter Wyvern to be able to save people from that.
Yeah, and we're looking at, yeah, okay, that's the AC complete now on Viper. So they're going to have the Assault Cuirass ready for the next high ground push from EHOME, and maybe that was what they were waiting for here.
Roshan is going to be up fairly shortly, potentially, as well. We're going to see just under a minute what the respawn timer is on that one. Maybe EHOME will play it super safe, just kind of hang on, wait to get the Aegis and the cheese, and then it's going to be so hard for Liquid to defend against that push with all those items taken into account.
Now their death timers are like long enough that death really does matter, and they're kind of have to use a buyback like every time two people, I think, are picked off. But at the same time, EHOME is kind of getting limited on item slots. He already has to drop items for the Aegis and the cheese. Old Chicken kind of approaching six fairly soon. I guess you can still top it off with Moonshot.
All right, top lane. CTY moving in. The hookshot will stop the TP and onto the range creep, but mind control just getting. Oh, CTY, no mercy here from the bear.
He doesn't have buyback. I think he bought back last fight.
He did buy back in the last fight, mind control. He's not been having his greatest of games, unfortunately for him on the clock. It's been a tough one here. And top lane, so they'll get the Kree wave coming back in on the top, mid lane. Old Chicken gets himself back onto the tower here. No clock well for 20 seconds. Father just moving out with the concoction. He's got 4.8k gold here on this Alchemist, so it's going to be very important what he picks up next. I mean, what do you think he's kind of contemplating at this point? As you said, maybe still holding on for the buyback gold.
Yeah,
but other than that, what does he get?
I think an AC of his own.
Okay.
Is probably the best bet. I mean, you can also go Halberd. It's pretty good, but Ursa already has a BKB.
Oh, Kaka with the Glimmer Cape. Looking to set this up, and Matuma Man's going to be able to get himself away with the Shadow Blade. No detection here on the Shaker. So he will survive. Gem at the moment, of course, being carried by 11 for the side of Eho. I mean, in the minds of Eho, do you feel this is a little bit of an issue? The fact that we are 42 minutes in, pretty much, they've got the lead that they have, but they have not yet taken down a Tier 3.
I think it's still okay. They can exchange out for BOTs fairly soon, and they have the tools that they need, like Blink, Gem, Glimmers. Like, these are the items that you need to
stop
these annoying Split Butchers. And Juggernaut's still like not that farmed. He had to invest in a Shadow Blade, which is not going to be very useful at defending the high ground. And they are still finding
mind control again, getting caught out. Oh, gets the hook shot away, and he'll be able to survive this time. Okay, nicely done there by the clock. Yeah. Nice little applause there for him not dying this time. Nicely played. 42 minutes in top lane. CTY slaying around Matumba Man. Can't really do a lot here, he's just going to TP out elsewhere. Have they got a smoke here? No, I guess they just play on the defensive really here, Liquid.
Yeah, they have to get these wards down. They changed the gem over to Fada.
Okay.
I mean, he can see the wards, but he can't actually take them out. I guess, at least not this high ground one. But they have to limit EHOME's vision at all times. And EHOME has to do the same. So they can, you know, kind of threaten a push with like two or three while they always have to wonder where the Earthshaker is going to be. Same with the Ursa. He can pick people off so easily with Blink Abyssal, but he just can't get to anyone.
Oh, CTY sees the courier pass over. That has got a full AC on. If CTY finds this, no, he's just going to go for the kill instead. Moves forward onto Kuroki. The bash is there. That's the Undying down. 45 seconds. Kuroki doesn't have buyback. Courier is going to be kept in on the cliff side for the time being, and they'll get it back safely, I'm sure. So it was indeed, as you called out, the AC purchase here for that Alchemist with that gold.
Yeah, he doesn't have buyback, but doesn't look like it'll be much of a problem unless he gets picked off right now.
Bottom lane, again, mind control, hook shots across to the Roshan to get himself out of here. He should be alright. He's got a TP up. I think hang on, CTY's there. Oh, the blink! And he's been trapped in his own pen as punishment there from 11. He says, you stay there and think about what you've done. Maybe they'll still get the kill though. Snowball forward, Old Chick is there as well. They will eventually find the kill here onto the clockwork, says. As much as mind control will try to get himself away from everything, it doesn't work out. And again, CTY will take the Roshan. I think this is pretty much the fifth time they've got it now in quick succession here on the side of EHO.
Still, I think it's a good time to push out all the lanes. All of them are past the river at this point, so still pretty good for them. Moon shards maybe left on CTY, and that's pretty close to it. Invisibility.
Father, 2.5k on his Alk at the moment on top of the AC. You've got CTY moving, and he's going to see the ward in Matuma Man. It's going to be fine. The night vision CTY makes a hazardous guess at which way the jug went. It's not going to be the right one. And Alk TPs himself out, so Matuma Man farming very aggressively here, but he feels safe, of course, because of this Radiant Observer ward. And he's just going to keep himself just clinging to those trees just to make sure that no one passes by and spots him out. 11 coming in with an invis. He's going to see Kuroki hit. He's going to try and go for a bit of solo action. We'll see. The pings are coming out. CTY's moving in as well. Kuroki is going to be in the low. Okay! Okay! They still get him here. They hold the punch off. And they'll get themselves the kill. Nicely done.
They're still sacrificing these like very low level heroes. I think Clockwork's level 12 or 13 and Undying's level 11. So their respawns are long enough that, okay, if they get caught out on the opposite side of the river, they'll be up in time for the push. And Old Chicken's trying to do his best, but without BOTs, he's kind of just a sitting duck.
All right, is this the complete X-ray? How much has he got in the current? Yeah, so you've now got an Aghanim's on this this AA as well, and Lanham's just hit level 16. That's not going to be great, and Mind Control's got to be careful. Hanging around in the jungle, there is 11 around. CTY pushing down the top lane. Bottom lane, the action's kicking off. They found Jarex this time in the trees, and they'll get the kill. Ice Blast on point. Lanham gets the kill for that one. This time Jarex won't get away. They're chilling in the sidelines.
They've had enough of shenanigans.
And an Old Chicken, I mean, he's just sitting there in mid. He's so damn tanky with the AC, BKB, and heart. He's got 3.7k gold on top of it as
this
well.
This is it, I think. This is the time. All three lanes are finally pushed in.
All lanes are pushed in, and the cheese on the Tusk. The Aegis on the Viper. He can just frontline pretty much infinitely. Panzer's going to throw out the concoction. Fortification has now been used here by the side of Liquid. So EHOME, I'm sure they're going to very much want to jump in. They're just lacking in Kaka at the moment. He's making his way down the mid lane to join the fight. CTY moves in onto the tower. What's going to be Liquid's response? Just using the Blade Fury here from Matumba Man. Now CTY trying to close in. The punch slow is onto Matumba, and they'll jump straight in with the Abyssal as well. There's the heal. Oh, but gets forced off out. He's going to live. Gets out the Omni Slash. Lando's brought incredibly low. Now he's going to walk himself away. Gets the Beekeeper out in time. So Matumba Man wants to find Mind Control with the hookshot forwards here. They'll get the return kill onto Lando. But they do lose the clock. Oh, Chicken. Still frontlining 11 again with these shards. Blocking Fartra out from getting away. He's looking for the Winter's Curse onto CTY. It's pretty big. CTY might just go down here. Will he go? Yes, he will. They'll kill the Ursa. And now, Kaka picked up by the Snowball. 11 buying time for the Shaker to live through this one. But he may still go down here. Gets four-staffed out. Matumba Man moving in here. Looking to find the cleanest. 11's there with a Rorsch Punch, though. Old Chicken just still sitting there, hitting away. And Matumba Man will get taken down. It's a double kill for Fana, though. And now they're looking for Old Chicken. Old Chicken, he's lost the Aegis. If they can kill him here, this could be huge. Kaka's going to throw out a Fissure to block them off in a nice Fissure. Front Kaka will buy the space here for Old Chicken to get out, but that was a very messy high ground push attempt there from EHOME, and Liquid, they punish it extremely heavily.
Yeah, they didn't really have to throw that many buybacks at that point, though.
Look at the gold XP swing. I mean, it's a swing of about 4k in gold and about 7k in terms of XP.
Finally, they see the T3. I thought that was a time for them to go. I mean, Viper can't really do that much. He's sitting there behind enemy lines and he still can't really focus people down. He went like a super heavy sustain build so that he can kind of push while dealing with the Alk illusions, but it's not really paying off for the actual team fight where they need to kill this Alchemist.
That's just got to be a huge wake-up call for EHOME. The fact that they can't break base with the lead that they had, and that Liquid, they don't even need to use any buybacks.
I think they can still get like BOT2s and keep looking for people. I would like to see like a Shadowblade pick up on the Tusk though, but he doesn't have enough gold. I didn't see the gem exchange hands, but it looked like it dropped sometime during the fight. Okay, Old Chicken with the Mjolnir pickup.
On top lane, Haka coming free. You've got the wards being chopped out by Kuroki as well. Kuroki's gonna be a bit careful here. He's doing reveals, he's actually gonna try and go for the kill. And Kaka will be able to get himself out with the Glimmer Cape. TPs are coming in here as well. Kuroki four-stopping himself away. He has got Mind Control here. But CTY closing in on the Undying. I don't know if Kuroki can get himself out of this one. The hookshot from Mind Control with the the force out. He goes for the TP. The Abyssal Blade is there. So they will get Mind Control. He does give his life to save Kuro though. I don't know if that was necessarily worth there from the clock. I mean, surely you'd rather keep the clock alive. Actually, guys, to be fair, just looking at the two heroes, how well Kuroki's been doing.
Mind Control doesn't care about dying anymore.
Yeah, that's true. He's kind of the sacrificial lamb here for the side.
Still having trouble pushing in against the onslaught of illusions.
We've talked earlier about how Fada's going to have to do a lot to hold on to this game, and he's been doing exactly what's been needed. 5k gold now saved up on top of the AC. I mean, is there a point soon where there's any kind of Aghanim's that you feel it's worth investing for the side of Liquid at this point of the game?
I guess only Juggernaut, but he doesn't even have that much damage to warrant it. Although the cooldown reduction is pretty nice, but maybe put on Undying, I guess? I don't know. He still has, what, BOT2s and replace a gem for something else. Abyssal, maybe? A Butterfly, I think. If you go Butterfly right now, yeah, sure, they can pick up MKBs, but they're, like, super limited on item slots. He's gonna have to drop his mask or something. And ideally, he wants another slot to carry the Aegis.
And Levin's now picked up a Vlad's as well. We do see, obviously, teams do that at the later Porsches just to help with these late-game fights. Just with the percentage base damage increase and just having that lifesteal as well for the team, it's going to be very nice for EHOME when they do jump into these fights. Roshan, it's only going to be up here for a few minutes at minimum. Have to wait on for that one, but 15 minutes in, you've got to imagine that EHOME are still a little bit worried that they can't quite break the base against Liquid's lineup.
Yeah, they have these reserve wards on the side though. They place one on bottom for Winter Wyvern, one on the left over here. These are not going to be dewarded by a gem unless he flies over. But
yeah, I mean, so as you were saying, so that the axe being given to Jug here, of course, by the Alchemist, it is going to be pretty much, yeah, having that 70-second cooldown, because we've seen a lot of the times as well just used to kind of buy time and save Matuma's life and more mind control. KTY just jumps straight in and finds a free pickup on the clock as he wanders through the jungle here. Just continuing to confidently move around the map. CTY just having no fear at all about how deep he goes here into the jungle. There's going to be bots now on old Chicky's Viper. This game has suddenly become very tense between these two sides. One slip up could quite easily cost the game here for Liquid.
I think that maybe they can split push with like one side using like a Viper as a siege engine and then the other like having the Ursa or something like that, but still no gem. Kaka does have sentries available to him, but not willing to drop him at this point. I think that the Viper can kind of tank through like almost everything that Liquid can throw at him, especially if they throw solar on him.
Alright, picks around to Matabanez, he just clears, tries to cut the way, but there's already a large creep wave moving in on pretty much all of these lanes here. MKB now picked up on the Ursa, just to kind of deal with that Radiant's mischance that Alk's kicking out.
So, how many roaches is it going to be? Number 5?
I mean, this is number 6 now.
6?
It's been a lot, yeah. Back up in a few minutes.
I've lost count.
And yeah, so I mean, with the Mjolnir on Alchik, he's putting out a fair bit, and obviously something as well to deal with the illusions to get sent down the lanes. Just to make sure that EHOME do constantly have all the waves pushed in when they look to fight. Mind Control and Timberman coming out a little bit on the top lane. They might just look to try and fight this with the three of them here at EHOME. Wrapping around the sigil, spotting it out. I mean, this is just the two on Liquid, jumping with the Walrus Punch onto Matumba. He's getting himself out of the shards here, but Mind Control, gonna take a nice blast to the face. So they'll get the clock once again. Matumba's still hanging around. Looks for the Omni Slash onto Kaka, but the Glimmer Cave's there. He'll walk it off now with the mech. The Omni Slash is just not gonna do enough. The Culture, but the Snowball comes in. Winter's Curse, the Snowball's gonna be held on here. Turn to Matumba Man, maybe they could do it here. They fell on CGY, play with low pots to be, gonna be touched around. On him, around the clock, he braces there for Jarak. He's gonna live. 11 and Old Chicken trying to do it. Old Chicken just frontlining. We've got Matumba Man gets himself forced out here. Vada being slowed up by the Viper. Old Chicken trying to move forward here. Lana as well. Blink in from 11. Looking for a Snowball stun. We'll get it. He's got the shards as well. Throws him out of the corner base once again. Keeping alive Vada. Jack's just saving his team. CG White came in from the side. Managed to finish off Brokey on the entire. Vada trying to man fight this. He may just die here. The Ice Blast coming through, but Vada. Oh, he gets himself out of the Ice Blast. Doesn't matter. They'll still find the kill. Old Chicken getting forced forward. They wanted to try and get Matumba Man. Again, Jack's with the corner base, but Jarax himself dies. Matumba Man has been left. It's a buyback from Jarax. The buyback from Fado here as well. Now EHOME, they're going to get themselves out both incredibly low here, but EHOME still finding a very, very good kill there.
Nice cold embraces coming out, but not enough to save them. That's one buyback down for the Alchemist.
Yeah, and this is the point where you've got to be careful with the fact that these buybacks, because now EHOME, they'll want to look to try and go for the same amount of aggression as quick as they can. There's still an Echo Stamakaka. One shot in from line control here. Okachiji can post the BKB now. The damage, they'll be able to find the clockwork. Cold Embrace is not going to save. Echo Stam coming out a bit preemptively here. Okachiji getting pushed back by the cogs. There's a buyback on Matumba Man as well as he comes back into the fray, but they can't quite catch out the side of EHOME as EHOME play it safe and they get themselves the hell out of there.
They need some sort of sustain on the Ursa though. Like, the old school build used to be like Heart Scythe, but with the ulti change, it's much different now. And unfortunately, he doesn't have any slots for lifesteal, so like once he's low from Winter's Curse, he has to back out of the fight immediately unless they want to commit to like a buyback and BOT back in. So ideally you can kind of slot one out for ages, but
he's got the Vlads on the Tusk, so
yeah, that's unfortunately not enough.
Yeah, it's
decent. They wish probably had something like Healing Ward now.
Bottom lane, CTY. I'm not gonna jump in it. It's just the illusions being put out here. Harder just getting those waves pushed back up, and the Roshan, yeah, is up and available. Old Chicken will head in. He'll spot that one out with the go ahead. Bottom lane, Lana was pushing in this lane here. Jax is moving out here. He's got to be careful with CTY. They're just jumping and going for the kill. Oh, yeah, gets the Abyssal down in time. And Jax, gets himself away. Not going to save him. He still finds with their CTY. So he gets himself the kill. Old Chicken in 11 looking to finish off Roche. Rocket Flare will spot it out, but this is a point as well where Jarex is now down for 75 seconds. Did, of course, buy back in that last fight. Mind Control moving forward with the smoke. Okay. I mean, it's flashy. I don't know if it matters. It was flashy, though. I'll give him that.
CTY-wise, like, whatever. I didn't have a slot anyways.
Yeah, I mean, it looked good, but it didn't really achieve too much here, unfortunately. Stops them from getting the Aegis, I guess, which is what this is all about, kind of prolonging EHOME from pushing up to the high ground. And I guess Mind Control's got a pretty fairly short respawn timer still. So he's going to be back for the defense.
Keep the levels low, man.
So maybe, just taking the Aegis off the hands of EHOME is worth it. Bottom lane, Matuma Man is going to find CTY here. Maybe this is the play. So CTY, of course, doesn't have an Aegis here. If they can get him here, they can't. The BKB's there, and he's just going to walk it off. That could have been big, though. Mid lane, EHOME. They're going to get the pressure and fortification coming out from the side of Liquid. There we go. So, Rax. Now find the melee, probably the missed chance here from the Raider. He can't get the last hit in. All these misses, there we go. Finally gets it. So I'll take the melee, Rax. So clock is back here. And we'll see. But yeah, maybe in hindsight. So yeah, just taking the Aegis. It's going to make EHOME feel a little bit more scared about pushing. But who took the cheese? Cheese is on 11 again. Okay. Amatuma Man. Trying to move in with the Omni Assassin to Old Chicken, but Old Chicken's sliding around here. The Abyssal Blade for Fada, though, locked in place. Fishing comes out of Kaka. Now there's a hook shot from Mind Control. Pushing back Lana, the snowball, though, across, and they've already lost the dirt here. Old Chicken with the BKB looking for Fada. Of course, he gets thrown at him. Matuma Man trying to move in with the BKB. Hasn't quite got the damage, though. Ice Blast being flown across the fight, and 11 moves in. Morris punch on the Matuma Man, Blade fearing himself away that it's junk. Fada trying to move back here. Jarex getting the slow out onto CTY, but CTY, and he's trapped in the cogs here with Mind Control, but he just turns onto the clock and takes down Mind Control. They did manage to find the melee racks on the top lane as well now. So this is getting harder and harder for the side of Liquid to defend. Two sets of melees down. EHOME still pretty strong. They're going to be happy hanging around here. And 40 seconds on clock. 30 seconds on and dying.
No buybacks.
Yeah.
On Radiant. I mean, they have such good terrain control too with the Fissure and the Ice Shards. Fada was almost locked into that fight, and you don't want to be locked in the cage with Ursa Bear.
Okay, and this is going to be tier 3 on the bottom. They are going to have the Undying back, but Liquid, they need an insane team fight to do this. Oh, Chicken pops the BKB. Fada gets the Abyssal down. CTY jumps onto Jarex. The Jarex. The pitch as well from Old Chicken. They'll lose the Alchemist here. Omni Slash comes out from a Tumor Man, but it's not enough to kill anyone here. Bounces around. Now they all converge on him. Mind Control hookshots back in, but he doesn't stop the aggression of EHOME. They're 3-4 down. GG. It's called. And EHOME take down Liquid 2-0. 58 minutes in. They took their time with it. And Liquid, they did their darndest to hold the base, but it just wasn't enough at the end of the day.
That might be the solution to Alchemist. Hopefully we start
Ursa Bear. Just running at him and killing him at 1 minute mark, 2 minute mark, and three. It was, yeah. The Ursa from CTY was absolutely on point. Ends the game 27-6-4. Insane performance from the man. But obviously, shout out to the admirable play from, obviously, Fada on the Alchemist. He did his best to just buy time for the game, keep it going. But it wasn't enough at the end.